Welcome to KUKA, ladies and gentlemen, and we are now here in our production hall in Augsburg. Our topic for today is robot-based friction stir welding, applications and solutions for the electromobility. My name is Till Meyer, and I'm the responsible portfolio manager for advanced welding solutions. And with me there's Stefan Fröke.
Hello everybody, my name is Stefan Fröke and I am the responsible welding engineer for the technology of friction stir welding.
Electromobility is a huge trend and everybody is talking about it. So there's global growth for new applications and everybody is seeking for the right production technology. So here we want to focus on friction stir welding. But besides this, there are also other applications that you need to weld. So we have the battery contacts, for instance, we have cables for high voltage applications, we have rotor shafts and drive shafts, for instance, and also rear axles that can be joined with rotary friction welding as well as magnetar welding. But there is a huge demand for battery cases and also for enclosures for power electronics. And this is what we want to focus today, because here we have the right process in place, which is called friction stir welding. Well, before we get into details, Stefan, could you explain the process a little bit more for our audience?
Yes, of course, sir. Let's have a look at our video. I think there we can see the most important information about the process. So the friction stir welding process was developed by the TWI in 1991. The friction stir welding process is a solid state process. It means that we are not melting the material we want to weld. So how does it work? We have a tool which consists out of a shoulder and a pin. Both is rotating and getting in contact to the workpiece. Because of the friction, we are generating heat and intermix the material. Here we can see one of our applications where we're going to weld a battery housing. As you can see here, we have our KUKA robot system with a spindle, which drives our tool. The used tool is a stationary shoulder tool, where only the pin has a rotation and not the shoulder. As you can see here, we are welding a battery housing, which is made out of casted aluminum. And here we want to seal a cooling channel.
All right, so now hopefully you have understood the process. But what are the benefits actually for this process?
So friction stir welding has a lot of advantages. One advantage is the really high welding quality. It means we have, in comparison to other welding processes, no defects like pores or cracks or anything like this. We are also able to weld a wide range of different materials together. Moreover, we have really less heat input, which means that the distortion of the parts we want to weld is a little bit less. Friction stir welding is also called as a green technology because with friction stir welding, we have a low heat input. We need no filler wire. We need no shield gases. We have no pollution for any chemicals or anything like this. So all in all, I think friction stir welding has a lot of benefits.
Well, good to hear that. Green technology. Everybody is talking about green technology. But let's stay with the battery and cooling cases. What are the typical welding tasks that need to be performed?
So when we are speaking about welding tasks in e-mobility, we have a really wide range on different applications. I want to explain you maybe three of it. Let me start with the first one, the hybrid electric vehicles. Here we have some smaller battery housings, which are made of casted aluminums. And this aluminum casted housings have also somehow cooling channels. And our task is to close these cooling channels. Another one is a battery housing for a real electrical car. These battery housings are much more bigger and have much more higher weight. So it means all the components or a lot of the components are made of different aluminum alloys. The most important here is to weld with a really high welding quality in terms of crash behavior. And the third one is battery housings for smaller electronic components. Here we also have some casted housings with cooling channels, and we have to close them really tightly.
Mm-hmm. And what are the typical materials that need to be joined?
So we have different aluminum alloys we are going to weld. We have aluminum plates made of the series, aluminum series 6000, 5000 or 3000. But we also have casted aluminums. And we are able to weld all together. So dissimilar and aluminum to aluminum.
Okay. And let's come back to the requirements that come from our customers. What are the exact requirements, especially from the automotive industry? And how can friction stir welding be an advantage to these?
With friction stir welding technology, we have, I think, the right technologies for especially these products. One thing I can mention is that we have some requirements in terms of flatness for the mounting areas of the batteries. And with friction stir welding, we have a very low heat input when we compare it with other welding technologies. So that means that we have less distortion. Another thing is that we want to seal cooling channels. So it means we want to cool the batteries, we want to cool the housing. That's why we have to weld in a really high welding quality without any pores, without any cracks. And the third one is when I think about battery housings for pure electrical vehicles, these are structures which have to have a very high strength because of the crash behavior. And that's why it's really important that we have here a really strong weld line.
Okay, customers often argue that robot-based friction stir welding will not meet their requirements as they are not stiff enough and they cannot accommodate these high process forces. And that's why they cannot achieve the high precision, for instance. So often they think that gantry systems, large solution, very stiff, but also expensive investment, are the better solution. What do you think?
I think here in KUKA we have the right answer for your question, because here we are using a really special robot system. The robot system is called KR500 from the Fortex series. This robot has some stiffer gears and is really high in accuracy. Moreover, we have developed some kind of a pass calibration system. It means we are measuring during the complete welding process with a laser tracker the position of the robot and are able to react online just in time. So this is a tool where we can keep the robot on track. That's why I think the robot system is really able to handle the high forces during the friction stir welding process.
Okay, good answer to our customers. Well, of course, the automotive industry always demands very economic and cost-effective solutions. And if I look at the process itself, then I see there the pins and the shoulders are the wear parts of the whole process. So more or less they are consumables because they have to accommodate the high process forces. Furthermore, they think that rework is not necessary or should not be necessary. That's why they require a high quality of the surface. So what can KUKA offer here?
Well, the world of the different friction stir welding tools is really wide. Yeah, we have a lot of different tools in our portfolio. We have the conventional tool where the shoulder is rotating and the pin is rotating. We also have the stationary shoulder where only the pin has a rotation and the shoulder is without any rotation. There exist bobbing tools and so on. From our experience, we think that with the stationary shoulder welding tools, we have here the best solution. Because here we can generate a really high welding quality, a really smooth and even welding surface, which makes the risk of the rework really, really low. So that's why I think we have here the right answer for your question.
So in order to avoid expensive recalls, process reliability and documentation of the whole process and its parameters is a key and a must requirement from the large car manufacturers. So how is this taken into account?
I'm absolutely with you, Till. It is really important that we have a transparent recording of all process relevant data. So here we have a solution for this. It's called the PCD. It's a process control and documentation unit. With this system, we are able to monitor and save all the relevant data of the process. And it is very easily to exchange these data via the OPC UA system.
All right, so now we have understood the whole process, and let's have a look at our portfolio. In the chart, you will see that we have three different solutions for you ready. So the one is the friction stir welding application module, which is the basis for our process that consists of the robot, the technology package, as well as the software and hardware. So this is a universal module where you can build up your own cell, which you can integrate into your production line. It is for easy, but also complex joining of 3D seams. It is the ideal combination for the cost-effective welding of non-ferrous materials. So aluminum up to 8 millimeters can be joined. It features a large working area and which can be expanded by using linear axes. And it's a very low investment in comparison to gantry systems. We have recently launched a new series, a new Cell 4 series we call Cell 4 Friction Stir Welding. So this is available right now. You can have it as a mid-size cell or as a large cell. So what are the highlights of these two cells? As I said at the beginning, process efficiency is important for our customers. That's why we are using two separate working stations and separate protection areas. That means that the robot is always working. So in the one station, the operator can set up the process, while on the other, the robot is processing its task. So it's very flexible. And on the other hand, it is a very modular approach, as it is based on the friction stir welding application module. So this is a typical application for welding battery enclosures and power electronics for hybrid plug-in hybrid cars. It's very space saving, and if you want to increase the productivity even and reduce the cycle time, then I would advise you to the Cell 4 Friction Stir Welding Large that features two robots, which has the same approach. So here we also have a very high process efficiency of up to 95%, as we have two working stations. But here, two robots can work on the same welding task, which reduces the cycle time by 50%. So this is a dedicated solution for larger battery cases, which we have in our full electric vehicles. All right, so this is our standard portfolio, but on the other hand, we have demanding customers who want not have only the standard. Is that right? That's why we have very complex lines. If I go through our production halls, well, I have very interesting projects. Can you talk a little bit more about these?
Yes, of course. Thank you. We have a really interesting project in the moment here in Augsburg, where we not only have the welding cell itself, so it means the robot system, the clamping system and the tools. More than this, we also have the complete pre and post-processing. Pre-processing in terms of marking the parts with a QR code, for example, and the complete data line, and post-processing afterwards, then in terms of cleaning all the weld lines with some grinding processes, and as well the handling of the complete battery housings and all of these components. So with this project, we have not only the welding task, we can use the complete strength of KUKA in terms of automation.
All right, thank you very much for giving us some more insight on our very complex cells, which we will build and which are definitely turnkey solutions, where we can also provide a CE mark, for instance. Now let's have a look at the typical customer request, because it's not only the portfolio we can offer, we can also offer services, is that right? So what is a typical, inquiry when a customer comes to us. So does he only has an idea or does he has a typical product in mind which he wants to buy?
So from my point of view, KUKA is the right partner, just even for the first idea of a product up to the completely finished turnkey solution. So with our engineering team, we are able to make the really first investigations on the part in terms of design guidelines and so on. But we are also able here in Augsburg with our technology center here to make the very first prototype weldings and also testing in our laboratories. Moreover, we are also able to produce a higher number of prototypes.
Mm-hmm. So that means contract manufacturing, what we can also offer. So this is a good example. So if you don't want to invest so much money into production facilities and in these cells, then you can also ask us to do the production for you. Well, Stefan, you are traveling a lot and it's hard to get you here on this booth. Well, can you talk a little bit more about your customers? Where are they located and what kind of customers do we have?
Yes, of course. This is really interesting because we have a really wide range of different customers. We have customers in the OEM sector, tier one, supplier, or even in R&D, some universities. So you see the tasks are really different. It's really interesting.
Okay, so if I look at my statistics, I can see that we have sold more than 80 frictional stir welding robots. So that's a huge demand we have in the field. And if I look at the location, I thought more than 60% are located in Asia, in Korea, in China, and so on, because there is e-mobility. And on the other hand, we have 30% in Europe. So Europe is also catching up with e-mobility. This is a trend we can see. All right, so this makes us the market leader for friction stir welding. Not only friction stir welding, but robot-based friction stir welding, right? Correct?
Absolutely right, yeah.
All right, so ladies and gentlemen, you have seen that we can provide you with the right solution, with the right service, and now we are keen on you to give us feedback whether you need the solution. And that's why I like to thank you for your attention. And if you have any requirements, we are very keen to help you. Stefan, myself, and all the team. So thank you very much for your attention and goodbye.
Thank you very much. Have a nice day and goodbye.
Industrial intelligence.